Rolling now, interview with Senator Aquino. Senator, do you think that the Filipino students will be emerging as a political force?
Eventually they will. I think there is a qualitative development now. Previously, you only got about 500 students going to the streets. But lately, as a result of the police brutality that occurred on January 26th, now you have 10,000, 15,000. And this qualitative development, I think, goes on geometrically, so to speak. And most of the students all over the country are joining in. They will be definitely a force.
Are they already a political force?
Not yet, in the sense that they cannot yet elect a man. But however, if we had an election today and they supported one of the candidates, I think definitely they will be a tremendous plus on whoever they will side with.
Are they already an influential group?
Oh, a tremendous influential group. In fact, last year, we could hardly get a quorum at this time of the year in Congress. But right now, every congressman's coming in because the kids are watching and they're denouncing them, so they're all coming in. And the other day, the majority floor leader was just talking to a group of congressmen and a group of senators, and he said, well, let's watch our step now. Those kids out there might start denouncing us in the street. So this is one of the salutary effects of the student movement. It brought in some conscience searching among the legislators and government officials.
Is the student situation today, the student force, different from other demonstrations of student strength in the past 15 years?
Yes, because previously the students demonstrating were demonstrating on something abstract. You know, they talked of American imperialism. Now, whoever thought of American imperialism? They talked of some notions of injustice, but they don't specify. But right now they're talking of corruption. They're being specific. They're talking of police brutality. Everybody saw this on television. They're talking of officials amassing wealth, and they're specifying this. They're talking about the corruption of society, of conspicuous consumption, of very few wealthy and tremendous poor in this country. Now, this is ringing a bell not only among the students, but among the segments of society. And this, I think, is the healthiest sign.
Have the students found, generally speaking, a responsive, sympathetic core throughout the country?
Yes, they had a tremendous response on January 26, especially when about 4 million Filipinos saw on their television how they were being clubbed by the policemen. However, when burnings occurred and again the people saw how the kids went into a little excesses, it sort of eroded that sympathy. But definitely, the people in our country feel that the students represent a very fresh wind. They have no vested interest. They have nothing to fight for but their idealism. And this, I think, is a very healthy sign. And this is the cause for the tremendous sympathy for them.
Do you think the influence of the students will continue to grow?
Yes, definitely. I think the students here have come and they will stay as a tremendous influence. The threat of these students actually taking to the street has posed not only clear, present, and imminent danger, but it has made better officials of all of us. In fact, they've been demonstrating for 10 years, who cared? But when they massed 10,000 or 15,000, even the president had to calm down, and I think it had a tremendous chastening effect on Mr. Marcos.
Do you think that the students may resort to violence to achieve some of their objectives?
Eventually, if we become indifferent, if we are lackadaisical in this approach, if we don't listen to their demands and heed it fast, I'm afraid that the next escalation will be violence. In fact, there's already a group of students who believe that only through violence can they wake up people. Now, if they don't resort to violence, nobody pays attention to them. At the same time, there is a big segment among the establishment who feel that this has come about and therefore don't allow or don't wait for the violence. Let's do the reforms now. And this is gaining. As I said, it is qualitative and this is very contagious.
There are some rumors, shall we say, of the fear of violence among... There are some rumors of the possibility of the military, for example, staging a right-wing coup to keep the students in their place and to prevent any excess in reforms. Do you think there's any chance of the military acting here?
No, I don't believe that. I have been a very close student of military affairs. I have been a reporter covering the military. We have a very hardcore professional soldiers. They're loyal to the Constitution. They're loyal to the flag. But I don't see the military taking over in spite of all of this talk about the military coup. They're not just made for it.
Let me ask you this, Senator. How would you describe the political coloration of the student movement today?
Right now, they have no political coloration. They are not identified with any one party. In fact, you might even say they're nihilist. They are suspicious of everybody. They are actually aggrieved with society. But the first party that will articulate more or less their own aspirations most probably can draw their sympathy. But at the moment, they're non-political.
You think there's any chance of the extremists, that is to say, the extreme left elements in the student society taking over the student movement?
No, unless, of course, we push the students to the wall. If the moderates do not achieve what they want through peaceful means, in other words, the students will not get the reforms that they're asking for, and we become indifferent, then we will be pushing them to the radicals, and then only violence most probably can bring about change, and the radicals will have triumphed. Now, I am sure a great segment of our society realizes this, and because of this, I think the moderates will get what they want, and they will be strengthened over the...
As it's developed here in the last few weeks, may turn out to have a beneficial impact on...
Tremendous beneficial impact. In fact, I think, you know, the students have done what we should have done long ago, but since most of us now are politicians and we're afraid to rock the boat, so to speak, because we might all sink in the boat, and everybody who has a vested interest refused to respond, the students, and I'm glad that they've done it, are doing exactly what we should have done long ago, and I say more power to them.